kisses sweeter than wine. Sugar and spice and all things nice. You know that little girl is mine. Everybody stops and stares at my baby when she's walking down the street. People passing by just look at my baby, but my baby looks so sweet. You know she's sugar and
different from other people because she's very honest. Our relationship is just very open. She's such an encourager. That's just who she is at heart. She's a servant. She loves to encourage other people.
I think the things that set Becky apart from anybody else I know, the first word that comes to mind is commitment to me and to her friends, to the people she loves outside of the Lord. I mean, her commitment to the Lord is phenomenal, and I've time and again got to witness how Becky lets nothing come between her and the Lord. I've watched her make hard decisions, but she's never wavered. She's known right from the beginning her commitment is to the Lord.
She just really strives to know God and strives to just to please Him, and she just always wants to know Him more and wants to do what she can to find out what He's teaching her. Like at the beginning of our relationship, I was going through a really hard time. And she was totally there right beside me, writing me encouragement notes, calling me a lot, and just making sure I was okay. And whenever I am going through hard stuff and I let her know that, then she'll definitely be right there.
She's just stood beside me with this patient endurance, waiting for me to come out more refined, and it's just been amazing.
She was the center of our student leadership team. Like, she was the core. Like, everything revolved around Becky. Everyone loved her. Everyone was calling her. She was calling everyone. All the guys had crushes on her. She was the center of it all. We talk so much and just talk about life and what we're going through. And she sticks to her values a lot. She's got very core values, and she knows what she believes, and she's not gonna waver from that.
She's victorious. And in order to be victorious, you have to fight the fight. And she's not afraid to fight. She's not afraid to battle in her heart and in her mind with things that are difficult, with things that other people quickly throw aside.
With every situation she faces, you know, even though it might be tough, she knows what she should do. And she knows the truth.
Hard times aren't just hard times. They're a time to be refined. And so with Rebecca, it's never just grief or it's never pain, but it's pain with hope or pain with a purpose or struggle with an outcome. It's always two things, never just the bad.
She's very level-headed, and she looks at things the way they are. And she's been through a lot of rough stuff in life, and I think she really looks at things realistically.
There's so many things I wish that I could etch out and write down. Things that I wish I could brand on Rebecca's heart. And if I had her here right now and I could never see her again, I would say, Rebecca Parker, soon to be Larson, don't ever forget that life is more than what we see in front of us. You've always taught me that, and don't ever forget that people that are rough around the edges like myself, there's gems inside, and you're really good at finding them. And I would encourage you to stand strong, Rebecca, and stand beside Paul and love him like you've always dreamt of loving him. And remember that I love you. I would tell her that. I love her. I will always love Rebecca. She will forever have etched a beautiful picture on my heart and made me who I am.
Rebecca will always be such a dear friend. I will always keep in touch. I love her to death. I would do anything for her. And I'm so happy. I couldn't be happier for her that she's with Paul, and he's going to be great for her, and he loves her so much. Remember when we used to talk about what our husbands would be like, and, you know, dream about our husbands back in high school, and it's amazing that.
Things that really makes Paul special to me is his servant's heart, and that's always stood out to me. When I was a sophomore, and I kind of had my first real bout with depression that year, one of the things that pulled me out of that was when Paul decided he was going to throw me a surprise birthday party. When I walked in to that surprise party, and I saw what he did, I knew that he loved me and that he cared about me, and that has meant so much to me.
The thing I appreciate about Paul the most is his willingness to be there for me at any time, and anybody. Many times he's sacrificed himself and said, yes, I want to support you. I believe in this project. I want to be there for this event in your life. And he has done anything possible he could to be there and to do everything in his power, and sometimes beyond.
I really think that Paul also has a love for people that just doesn't end. He's very tenacious, so when he clamps onto something, that's it. Even if he's getting dumped on, if I'm totally dumping on him, he'll turn right around and he'll still love me. And that's amazing to me to see that in him.
He's very devoted. When he puts his mind to something, he gets it done. He's an encourager along the way, and he's allowed me to see things from a different angle that I probably wouldn't see him any other way unless I saw through his eyes. I'm in this accountability group, and we'll talk about things, and he'll bring up something. What about this, John? Did you think about this? And I won't see it from my point of view, but he'll show me, and that's been a great thing about Paul.
Instead of just thinking about God, Paul does something in God's service, and that really has influenced me to see that example as well. He knows what he wants to do, and he does it. He knows he wants to be a financial planner. He knows he wants to be married. I mean, he knows he wants to serve God, and he doesn't sit on that. He does it.
Paul's personality and mine is very much the same in the sense that we're both pretty driven. He's been able to say, John, in your life, I do it this way too, and it's not good, and I've been able to do the same. And that's really been great because
a lot of times when Paul hits a wall, he'll stop and he'll think about it. And it's cool to watch his reaction because his reaction is always, okay, God, what are you trying to teach me, first of all? And then second of all, how can I change? And that's been amazing to watch in him.
Actually, the beginning, he kind of took me in and we went to the state fair right away. My first year at Northwestern, and he'd already been here a year, and we've hit it off well. We both are go get him. And we then more and more as the semester went on, I found myself in his and Jared's room more and more, just hanging out, just to say hi.
I see a real balance in there. Relationship. And Becky's more, I see her as a very complex person with a lot of depth to her, and Paul has a lot of depth in as well, but it's in a different way. Paul is more straightforward, just more simple in his approach to life. I think one of the biggest things that Becky brings to Paul is getting him to see that life is not, it's not about the destination that you're getting to. It's a part of it, but it's about that travel along the way and what you can see along the way. I love Paul. There are a select few in my life that will ever hear those words. And whether that's a good thing or a bad thing, I don't know. But nonetheless, I love Paul. And there's one title for him that will always be reserved for him, and that is best friend. Those are my parting thoughts.
Life can be so good. Life can be so hard. Never knowing what each day will bring to where you are. Sometimes I forget. Sometimes I can't see. Whatever comes my way, you'll be
Pretty Dirt, Becky, soon to be Beck Dirt. This is coming from Neil and my wife Susie. Ask that God give you guys 5 things in your marriage. First, that he would give you wisdom so you would know what to do. I ask that he would give you courage so you would do what you know is right. I ask that he would give you justice so you would right what you know is wrong. I ask that God would give you passion so that nothing wrong would keep you from following him. And finally, I ask that he would give you endurance so that in following him, you may participate in the life everlasting.
Becky and I met my junior year of high school and Becky's sophomore year of high school here at camp, actually. I think it is just phenomenal to me how the Lord has worked in both of our lives. It really isn't anything but that, because I've watched the Lord work in each of our lives and bring us to the point of where we are today. I'm anxious to get married and to spend the rest of my life with somebody that truly sees the value of the things that matter. From this day on, I truly see Becky as being my teammate and as being the person that I will pour my life out for, and that I will make this commitment today as we are getting married. Understanding that I am hers and that she is mine. I love you, Beth.